Next guest, political pundit Tom DelBaccaro, who joins us now from his office to the north. Mr. DelBaccaro, when we last spoke, you said Trump is going to be was going to win re-election. Now that you see some of these mail-in votes coming in, are you going to back off that prediction?
Probably I have to. Look, they what happened in Michigan? They have same-day registration, and they had, and overnight, 330,000 votes difference made up. Same thing in Wisconsin, same-day registration, mail-in ballots, and suddenly 130,000 is made up. How does that happen? We're going to have to see. Georgia, you still have to count Atlanta, which is Fulton County. That could flip red. So blue. So there's a lot of questions as to how so much was made up after he led all night long, and we're just going to have to see. The Senate, on the other hand, the Republicans are at 48. They haven't called Alaska, but that's ridiculous. So there's five still open. Republicans are leading in all five. However, one of them's in Michigan, so I can't count on that after last night. Two of them are in Georgia. Don't know what to make about that. And one of them's in Maine, where it's a razor-thin lead.
Tom, it is amazing how fortunes can change on a dime. A lot of folks were thinking four more years of Trump, and now you have to start pondering who is the next face of the Republican Party, and can the Republican Party ever win a national election again?
Well, you're looking at a permanently blue, or at least blue as far as the eye can see, Colorado. Arizona is troubling. It's trending blue after this. And then you have to look at Georgia. It's troubling there. Who's the kind of Republican who could win Michigan or Wisconsin? On the other hand, if Joe Biden wins and lasts for about a year and Kamala Harris is the president, you're going to see such a radicalism there that you could have a big snapback. So a lot of questions this morning, a lot of questions on how Democrats came up with so many votes in Michigan overnight. But here we are. And some of us are kind of chagrined. I'm in relative shock. On the other hand, in California, you have Daryl Issa up. He's going to win. You have deja vu all over again, as Yogi Berra would say, in Orange County, where Young Kim and Michelle Steele are one on election day, but there's counting to go. You have David Valadao also up in the Central Valley. Will mail-in votes take that away? And the one silver lining is it looks like Prop 15 is going to go down to defeat.
I hearken back to that. I cannot remember the author of the piece, but he was with Fox, V-O-X, Fox, and who predicted months ago that this very scenario was going to take place, and then Hillary Clinton telling Joe Biden not to concede. It's almost like this was preordained as far as the presidential outcome.
Yeah, there's a look. You have the AG in Pennsylvania all but saying that Biden would win there. So there's a lot of questions. This would be the tightest victory in history if Trump holds on to Georgia. You're looking at an electoral vote victory of 270 to 268, and talk about a divided era, which of course is my book. Yeah. And a lot of Republicans would not accept that as actually having happened. The number of incoming mail and calls I'm getting, texts saying that there's no way this is legitimate in Michigan, is troubling.
Well, it does. The big losers of all this, besides, I think, whomever the next president, whoever takes over the White House, they're going to be delegitimized by the other side. And I was just hoping for a decisive election one way or the other.
Yeah, no, 2 years ago, I said that this would be a close election. Remember, we haven't had a president reach 53% since 1988. We're clearly not going to have that now. And you're going to have a very, very divided country. On the other hand, if the Senate stays in Republican hands, even if Biden wins, you're not going to get that big tax increase. You are going to have, though, a regulatory war like you've never seen. And you know what? If you get Elizabeth Warren for Treasury Secretary, Wall Street, which funded Biden's victory, could wind up getting punched in the mouth by for all their efforts. And you know what? I think they deserve it because they would have sold out America for short-term profits because they think they're going to get quantitative easing through the Biden administration. And so they could get hit really hard.
Tom DelBacaro joining us, a weary Tom DelBacaro. It looks like someone's been up all night watching this. Sir, we'll speak again in the not-so-distant future.
All right, take care.
All the local ballot measures are expected to pass.